क्वेश्चन पूछ रहा हूँ खड़े सीधा ये तो पूछो ना मेरा उनका आना चाहिए Can I have the mic? Can I have the mic? Yeah.
Congratulations on your 10 years as Sikyong and all of your achievements, including the successful passage of the Tibet Policy and Support Act. I wanted to ask you, as you look ahead to the elections that are going to take place next weekend, what do you see as the biggest challenges for whoever is going to fulfill your role, especially with the rise? Everybody can't follow.
I think our election, the final round of election is coming next week. And what are the biggest challenges whoever is elected will face?
Especially with the rise in China's power.
You know, it's a Tibetan freedom struggle. So, which means it's always struggle. So, for 10 years, you know, it's a struggle. And whoever comes next will also have a struggle. And definitely, you know, China's rising power, political dominance, economic might, and their assertiveness, you know, all over the world will impact the Tibet issue. So, approaching the world and forming a coalition of like-minded countries on democracy and human rights, and pressing the Chinese government to improve human rights conditions in Tibet will be the biggest challenge. As I said in my statement, you know, some democratic countries sanctioned and banned some Chinese officials from entering these countries, and the Chinese government banned all these members of parliament, the scholars, and research to visit China as well. So China is very assertive. So definitely, how to appeal and form a coalition of like-minded countries is the biggest challenge.
Can I have the mic? Can I have the mic?
What is your plan if China does not allow the new Dalai Lama to be reinstated?
The reincarnation of all the Lamas and the Dalai Lamas have been our tradition. So we have been practicing that for almost 1,000 years. So the Chinese government or the Communist Party of China, you know, might interfere, but they have zero credibility and zero right to do so. Number one, it's a spiritual religious matter and for religious leaders to decide. And it is for His Holiness Dalai Lama to decide on his reincarnation. The Chinese government has no say whatsoever. Number one, first thing after the occupation of Tibet, they destroyed 98% of monasteries and nunneries. They destroyed 99% of monks and nuns. Even today, they're destroying monasteries and nunneries, right? So as far as their action is concerned, they've acted just opposite to the practices and values of the religion. And number two, the Chinese government might try to appoint a Dalai Lama or another Lama. But, you know, original is original, fake is fake. So we have the patent and copyright over reincarnation. So China is known to be a factory for manufacturing herbs of a lot of things, including some duplicates. But I think the original will be original. And that is the right of the Tibetan people to select their own Dalai Lama, which will be supported by Tibetan people first and foremost, and accepted by the larger world.
Excellency, but just a reminder, Excellency, Chinese say that they are also practicing communism and religion has no place there. And they also claim, go ahead and further say that they are practicing communism, which is a democracy.
Yes, that's what they say. There's a communism based in atheism. And why do you want to interfere in our religious matter? For example, with due respect, a communist leader in India appoints a Shankaracharya. How many Hindus will follow their Shankaracharya? Right. In India, it has been a practice for thousands of years. Hindu religion or other faith have elected or selected their own leaders, and that's the practice that has been going on. So that's what we have been doing, Tibetans, select our own lamas and follow our own lamas. So they have no role at all. Next.
Sir, this is Sanjay Agarwal. I'm present World News 24/7. My question is with what my friend has asked. You talk about China, what about Pakistan and the neighboring countries? And what about the Joe Biden administration? What is their role, and do you get extended support from them? And in India, when you say Tibetan government in exile, so India is the only friend, or do you have some other people?
We are guests here, so we don't comment on internal matters of India or the neighboring countries. However, we pursue human rights, and we do respect human rights for everybody. Now, as far as the US government, led by President Joe Biden, is concerned, when he was a presidential candidate, he said he would meet with the Solomon's Dalai Lama and he would support Tibetan people. He went further to say he would sanction those Chinese officials who have violated human rights in Tibet. And recently they have done so. So yes, the US government, irrespective of which party comes to power, will continue to support Tibetan issue because Tibet is a bipartisan issue. Now last December, during the pandemic, during the political crisis, right after the election in America, okay, when Republicans and Democrats were not necessarily getting along, they passed Tibetan Policy and Support Act. Now it's a law in America to support Tibet. Now, in that law, religious freedom, reincarnation, environmental issue of Tibet, democracy, all these are supported, including to open a US consulate in the capital city of Tibet, in Lhasa. If the Chinese government doesn't allow America to open a US consulate in Lhasa, then US government not allow China to open another Chinese consulate in America. Finally, I represent CTA. CTA is legally acknowledged in the Tibet Policy and Support Act. My office, Sikyong, is also legally acknowledged. So yes, India has done the most for Tibetan people, and now US government has legally acknowledged Tibetan administration and my office.
Another question now, about your
management. Let's give some other. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir.
Because it's a human rights issue. I can talk about spirituality, dharma, I can talk about social issue, I can talk about political, geopolitical. You give me one topic, I'm supposed to speak on human rights I spoke on. Now, as far as Tibet, Water Tower of Asia is concerned, Tibet has the third largest reserve of ice or snow after Antarctica and Arctic. The difference is, in Antarctica and Arctic, when the ice melts, it goes to ocean. But when the Tibetan glacier and ice melt, it forms rivers. So 10 major rivers of Asia flow from Tibet. Indus River.